There are a lot of very important discussions happening right now, literally right outside my apartment. There are protests going on in downtown Richmond, not far from me. And generally, when it comes to things like this, I don't like to open my mouth unless I have something new to add to the conversation. I just want to use my platform to promote voices that I know are making good points and are right. And I've been doing that on Twitter and Instagram. And to the people who have been telling me, like, shut up and just talk about books, you're largely responsible for why I'm snapping and finally making this video. But I also do have a bit of a unique perspective I want to add to this conversation, because I have a pretty interesting relationship with the American education system in this country, because I was schooled in Southern Virginia for a long time, that and briefly homeschooled due to not being able to get the IEP I need for my dyslexia, which that's a whole other thing. But eventually I moved up to Northern Virginia, or NOVA, and I went to a very well accredited school called Oakton, which the difference in the way American history was taught, just in this hour drive north, was extraordinary. I was lied to when I went to Southern Virginia schools repeatedly. It basically has taken me in my adult life to realize what was happening, but I was fed propaganda repeatedly. And I'm not saying this is everyone's experience. Maybe I just had a couple of really bad teachers. I'm not trying to say this is universal, but I know for sure it does at least happen. Because let's just get into some details. I was told after World War II that Japan wanted us to occupy them. I was on a smart board. Remember those terrible pieces of technology? My teacher put up a smiling America and a smiling Japan, and the two overlapped in the graphic. And it was like, look, they wanted us to occupy them. It was totally peaceful and willing. Are you insane? We nuked them twice. But I was told, oh, that's great. They loved it. I was told Vietnam was this righteous war and we kind of won it and all these other crap. It just wasn't true. It was just fed bullshit. And the civil rights movement maybe had a week total, barely got into Jim Crow, maybe touched on, a couple civil rights leaders, kind of said like Malcolm X is a bad guy, Martin Luther King was great. Didn't learn much more beyond that. Certainly didn't go into the Trail of Tears in depth. Maybe a day, if that. I seriously don't think it was more than that. I had maybe a few afternoons where we touched on the abuse of Asian immigrants, you know, the massacres that happened in the South. Just wasn't important. And of course, the crux of all Southern propaganda when it comes to this stuff, I was told the Civil War was about states' rights. And the fact that I just brought this up, I'm gonna get a bunch more downvotes and people are gonna leave and be angry. But it's omitted. They don't talk about the fact that when the Confederacy became traitors to the United States, they specifically said, this is about slavery. It's about white people being on top. They say that specifically. And I'm not trying to say every Confederate soldier went to fight to try and maintain slavery. I'm sure a lot of them didn't. And I'm sure some jackass is gonna point to the fact that some blacks did fight in the Confederacy while completely ignoring the circumstances around that because they think it proves some point that it absolutely does not. But you cannot validate the argument that the leaders of the Confederacy were not fighting that war about slavery, because they absolutely were, and you can find quotes of them saying that. Further evidence goes beyond. I mean, you can just see they wanted the federal government to be more powerful when it came to limiting northern states' rights to help rescue slaves. But they don't teach that in southern schools. I certainly wasn't taught it until I went to NOVA, until I started reading outside my bubble. And that's the point I want to talk about here. It wasn't until I went to a better accredited high school with a vastly better instructor that I started learning about things like Black Wall Street, the true extent of Jim Crow, how recently the last lynching happened here in the United States. All things that are just completely glossed over or not touched on when I was down south. But just that hour drive north and a better teacher made me kind of pop that bubble. Granted, thankfully I was already open to this because I had parents who were educated and, you know, had told me more than the school I was in the South was telling me. So I was already very open to the greater instruction. This teacher I had went into detail about how we're still screwing over Native Americans to this day. And I'm not trying to say I'm this end-all be-all woke thing. No, I'm a white dude who's lived in the South and moved around a lot. And so this one thing I can speak on fairly well, and that is that the bubble of education in the South, especially if you don't have a couple of voices trying to correct course, can absolutely result in a warped view of American history, because you're not told the realities. You aren't told the slaves built the White House. You aren't taught about other civil rights leaders aside from MLK. I didn't learn about James Baldwin until I went to college, or Bayard Rustin, or James Farmer, who actually taught at UMW, the school I went to, and where I got to learn about the Freedom Rides in much greater detail than I was ever allowed to before. So this video is aimed at a very specific type of person who hopefully is willing to read beyond what they're fed in the public school that taught them about these things, because we are taught different versions of American history. One that decides to censor what actually happened, like the war crimes in Vietnam we committed, or the systematic continued oppression of Black people through the justice system, which again, I wasn't able to learn about till college. Like, of course it goes beyond the education system, right? That's not gonna solve all things. I didn't realize how much fear was involved with a Black man having to be pulled over by a police officer till a friend of mine told me how many times he's just been literally sitting in his car parked and had a cop come and make him get out. I've never been made to get out of my car. The last time I was pulled over was in Ohio when I did an illegal U-turn. By the way, Ohio has like really horrible U-turn laws, but that's beside the point. And I had, this is before I had medical marijuana, I had illegal weed in the car and had no fear I was gonna get caught with it, because there's no way the cop's gonna ask me to get out of my car. He's not gonna ask to check. He could probably smell it and he'd still be like, whatever, I don't care, and let me go. And he did, with a warning. In fact, when he left, he apologized for stopping me, because he was like, oh, you're from out of state, you didn't know, it's no big deal. Goodbye, sir. And I'm not saying that cops shouldn't treat people like that. I'm saying they should treat everybody like that. That's the kind of stuff that still I think about a lot. I was gonna do a review of Royal Assassin today, but I literally couldn't get my words out, because this is what's dominating my mind. How much I was lied to in public schools as a kid. Directly, I don't know if the teachers I had were willingly ignorant or flat out just lying to me, but it was absurd. And if you had a better education in the South, where you were told the details of how bad this stuff still continues to be in American history, great. But if you have not, do your reading. Look up speeches by, especially James Baldwin, is someone I continually enamored by his rhetoric and his ability with words. It's extraordinary. But read outside your bubble. Read outside what you were given by the curriculum that decided how you should view America. And maybe once you learn about things like Black Wall Street, which, for the love of God, people shouldn't be learning about for the first time because Watchmen decided to include it in a few episodes. How is that a thing? Read. I've been saying that in this channel for so long, right? Read about fantasy and sci-fi, but it also goes beyond that. Read outside your bubble. I read conservative stuff all the time because I think it's really important to try and understand where they're coming from, even if I really, really don't agree with them. I know very few people on the other side who do that for my beliefs, but hey, I'm not gonna stop. That's what this video is about. I understand it can come across extraordinarily preachy. I've been accused already with my posts on other social media of just doing lip service. I don't post donations I make because I think that's a little, I don't know. It's just something I don't agree with doing. But yes, I've been donating. I've been doing everything I can. And the least you could do if you're not going to support Black Lives Matter is at least read some stuff that maybe is from the other side of this extraordinarily important conversation. And if I can get one person to do that with this video, awesome. But to everyone who's just gonna comment all lives matter, dislike, unsubscribe, I have no problem pulling weeds from this community.